The family of giants you work for is throwing a fancy dinner party, and they all want to look their best. But there's a problem. The elder giant's favorite shirt is wrinkled. To fix it, you'll need to power up the giant iron. The iron needs two giant batteries to work. You just had four working ones and four dead ones in separate piles, but it looks like the baby giant mixed them all up. You need to get the iron working and press the giant shirt fast, or you'll end up being the main course tonight. How can you test the batteries so that you're guaranteed to get a working pair in 7 tries or less? You could, of course, take all 8 batteries and begin testing the 28 possible combinations. You might get lucky within the first few tries. But if you don't, moving the giant batteries that many times will take way too long. You can't rely on luck. You need to assume the worst possibility and plan accordingly. However, you don't actually need to test every possible combination. Remember, there are 4 good batteries in total, meaning that any pile of 6 you choose will have at least 2 good batteries in it. That doesn't help you right away, since testing all 6 batteries could still take as many as 15 tries, but it does give you a clue to the solution. Dividing the batteries into smaller subsets narrows down the possible results. So instead of 6 batteries, let's take any 3. This group has a total of 3 possible combinations. Since both batteries have to be working for the iron to power up, a single failure can't tell you whether both batteries are dead or just one. But if all 3 combinations fail, then you'll know this group has either 1 good battery or none at all. Now you can set those 3 aside and repeat the process for another 3 batteries. You might get a match, but if every combination fails again, you'll know this set can have no more than 1 good battery. That would leave only 2 batteries untried. Since there are 4 good batteries in total, and you've only accounted for 2 so far, both of these remaining ones must be good. Dividing the batteries into sets of 3, 3, and 2 is guaranteed to get a working result in 7 tries or less, no matter what order you test the piles in. With no time to spare, the iron comes to life, and you manage to get the shirt flawlessly ironed. The pleased elder and his family show up to the party dressed to the nines. Well, almost. Here's today's bonus riddle. Once again, there are 8 batteries, 4 working and 4 dead. A new model of the giant iron has 6 battery slots, but it only requires 4 working batteries to run. How many tries do you need this time to get the iron working? This riddle and bonus riddle come courtesy of our sponsor, Brilliant. Brilliant helps you develop your joy of learning by cultivating your curiosity, helping you understand how concepts fit together, and providing you with different ways of interpreting a scenario. Try them out at brilliant.org/TED-Ed, and the first 833 of you to use that link will get a 20% discount off the annual subscription.